Did you know that we are in a battle and God provides the armor? Well, stick around because today we're going to look at Ephesians chapter 6 and see how we can stand firm in God's truth. Well, hey there, my name is WayneWrz, and on this channel we are walking the journey towards Jesus together. You can subscribe to join our community and get a new Bible study video every Tuesday. Have you ever felt like you're not good enough? Yeah, me neither. I sometimes feel like I'm pretty good at some things, but not really good at anything. And sometimes I will let that feeling of not good enough keep me from even trying. I think, well, if I can't be the best, why even try? It can be so easy to let doubt and fear creep in, and we can let those voices keep us from even trying something. When we listen to those voices telling us that we're not good enough, it can give the enemy a foothold in our lives and keep us from doing what God has called us to do. In Ephesians chapter 6, we read, "Finally, be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the schemes of the devil. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers over this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand firm. Stand therefore, having fastened on the belt of truth, and having put on the breastplate of righteousness." The verses that follow tell us about the rest of the armor of God, and I would encourage you to go check that out. As we walk the journey towards Jesus, we are not promised an easy life, and it can be super easy to become discouraged if we want the Christian life to be one that is easy and comfortable. But we're in a battle, and we need to realize that. Imagine how poorly an army would do if they weren't willing to admit that they were in a battle. If we don't think we're in a battle, we don't need to take up and put on the armor of God. But this passage tells us that we have an enemy, and he is a schemer. And what are the devil's schemes, you might ask? In John 8:44, it tells us that the devil is a liar. And in the story with Adam and Eve in the garden, the devil was a deceiver. He deceived Adam and Eve. He took God's truth and he twisted it, and he got Adam and Eve to doubt God's goodness. The devil has schemes. He is sneaky, and we need God's power to stand against him. Up in verse 10 of chapter 6, it says to be strong in his power. We cannot stand against the devil on our own power, but we must rely on God's power and the strength of his might. And it starts with truth. What does God say about you? There can be so many voices telling us that we don't measure up, that we'll never be good enough, that we've done too much wrong. But what does God say about who you are? You are a child of God. You are created in his image. And he loves you so much that he sent Jesus to live as a man and to die on a cross so that you could have a relationship with him. Now, to me, that doesn't sound like a God who doesn't think you're good enough. Matthew Henry's commentary says that the armor is prepared for us, but we must put it on. We must pray for grace and use the grace given to us. The armor of God won't do us any good if we're not willing to admit that we're in a battle and put on the armor. But when we put on the armor of God, we can stand firm in his power and truth. This week, I hope you can stand firm in the truth of who God says that you are. Thank you so much for checking out the video. If you liked it, you can smash that thumbs up button, and you can share it with your friends and subscribe for new videos every week. Let me leave you with this question that you can answer in the comments and discuss with a friend, a parent, or a pastor. Who do you have who is speaking the truth of God into your life? There are a few more questions for discussion in the description below, so be sure and check those out, and we'll see you later, alligator. And this passage says that the armor is Matthew Henry. To subscribe, click on the circle on the left. To check out a friend's channel, click on that circle on the right. To watch a video that YouTube thinks you should watch, click that box in the middle,